One evening, I was strolling in the beautiful Japanese garden. Then, around the corner, I found a strange rock entrance. What's this? The passage went down into the ground. It's kind of creepy. Shouldn't I go forward?
Maybe it's scary.
Well, I'm actually more curious than scared. At the end of the passage, there were stairs to climb up. When I got out of the exit, I saw this view. Where am I? I didn't go in, but ran back. This all happened in Chōrakuen in Tamatsukuri Hot Spring, Japan. I decided to go back there next morning. But not by using the underground passage, by using an above-ground path. In this episode, we will explore what was there. Oh, interesting. Important members of the Japanese royal family visited Chōrakuen. In fact, that building was used as the Emperor Showa's accommodation when he visited Shimane in 1965. He also stayed here in 1982 during the Kunibiki National Sports Festival. After the Emperor stayed, anybody, even employees of the inn, were not allowed to enter. Only the inn's president kept the place open by ventilating it every few days. So this building had been closed and guarded, kind of a secret space. I heard that the underpath was for security purposes, like for the secret service. But in a moment of crisis, I think it could be an escape. The emperor's accommodation had never been seen by the general public for 36 years, but it was decided to open it to the public in May 2019 at the occasion of the era change from Heisei to Reiwa. This leads to the living room, where he relaxed. You know what? Now you can sit on the sofa.
I think I'm invited to the royal family today.
Works by local Shimane artists and the collections of Chōrakuen are also on display. I heard that the emperor strolled around the garden in geta clogs.
From here, we are going to enter the cafeteria or eating room of royal meal room.
What are these? Oh my God, these are the menus for the meals that the emperor had when he was staying here. He had oatmeal for breakfast, which is my favorite and I have every day. An omelette with creamy spinach and celery cooked in tomatoes sounds delicious. Glazed carrots sound nice too. The lunchbox had many local items. Matsutake from Tamatsukuri, sea urchin from the Izumo coast, and Shimane's brand rice, Nitamai. Like I experienced that in Chōrakuen's dinner, the royal table on October 3, 1982, also had various local and seasonal items. Look at matsutake from Tamatsukuri and persimmons from Matsue which are most delicious during the month of the royal visit. You can also see the famous local dish, Izumo soba noodles, on the menu. It's exciting to see high-quality seaweed as well from Uppurui, western tip of the Izumo region. Uppurui is a unique name written like these Chinese characters, which are commonly read as Juroku-to or Juroku-jima, meaning 16 islands or Island 16. There are multiple theories as to why this name is pronounced as Uppurui. For example, one theory says, Uppurui is originated from Uchiburi, which means the practice of taking seaweed. Beating the seaweed and drying it under the sun has changed to Uppurui. Another theory is that Uppurui means many curved inlets in ancient Korean. At this inn's dinner last night, I had soup with rich seaweed. I wonder if it also came from Uppurui. I also had meaty abalone at dinner. And interestingly, abalone in different styles, fermented, dried, or pickled, were one of important items at the royal table centuries ago, such as Heian and Kamakura times. Japan's royal table also had different dishes, as seen in Chūjiruiki, the guidebook on food arranged on a table, from the late Heian and late Kamakura periods. At special occasions, royals and nobles also had multi-meal banquets, including many rounds of sake. Various items such as pheasants, red snappers, carps, and octopi, as well as vegetables were served. At the end of the meal, sweet items were also served, such as dried fruits and yam soup seasoned with primodan sweetener, a vine plant called Amazura. Each room has beautiful details. Look at the transom. It's called Ranma in Japanese. Simple but pretty. And see the sliding screen and its knob, which makes the space feel special. Now we are entering the bedroom. Quite spacious. Sitting areas. Overlooking the beautiful garden. Now we are entering the changing room. This three-way standing mirror is great.
Sure.
I wish I have this kind at home.
Big mirror.
Furniture items that help to organize clothing and accessories. A dressing table with another set of three-way mirrors. This room is smaller than others, but it is well equipped and practical. I like it. Here and there, arts and crafts from Chōrakuen's collection are also on display. The furniture and collections are kept very carefully, as if they were new. But electronics tell history. What's this? This is a telephone line selector, which allows you to call different rooms of this building. It's interesting to see the national logo, which used to make all kinds of electronics such as air conditioners, washing machines, TVs, refrigerators, and rice cookers, to name a few. It later changed the company name to Panasonic, one of its popular product lines. This is a control panel, adjusting the air conditioner intensity, high, medium high, low, and off. The main light for the changing room and the one for the alcove. This said the head of female attendant. I think this button is to summon her. So the head female attendant came along on the royal trip and probably had her own room in this building to stay.
Oyudono, same name.
In pre-modern Japan, Royal bathrooms were also called oidono. How spring comes out from the faucet? I wish I had this kind at home. The bathtub is made of local hinoki cypress from Shimane Prefecture. It's divided into two parts so that the water from the faucet does not directly hit the body. It was built by a carpenter specializing in the construction of shrines, temples, and palaces. It's so nice to be surrounded by high-quality wood. Even the ceiling is filled with beautiful wood. Through the bamboo blinds, you can feel the breeze coming in while gazing at the gorgeous garden. And you can enjoy unique arts, architecture, and history. Such a fabulous experience. Thank you for watching. I look forward to seeing you in the future episodes.